Player 2, this is Player 1, plugging in.
Player 1 is initiating connection. Player 1 is online.
Player 1, this is Player 2, plugging in.
Player 2 is initiating connection. Player 2 is online. All players have successfully connected. You are now plugged into the Plug and Play podcast. Initiating startup sequence.
I guess we should probably do the podcast, huh?
Probably.
Hey guys, and thank you for tuning in. This is episode 133 of the Plug and Play podcast, the Plug and Play Zelda podcast. I am your host, Zach, and alongside me, as always, is Tim.
Welcome, minions.
This week, guys, you're watching us play the Switch. If you want to talk, you can. I'm just playing.
Okay, guys. So,
alright, so we should probably actually do a podcast. And probably start out by shutting the door, huh?
Sure. So this is where I tell you what she
was being good.
I know. I kicked the box and she freaked out.
So this is the part where I talk about what we did this week. Yep. Obviously, one of the big things I did this week was pick up a Nintendo Switch.
But, you picked it up.
But before that, I saw...
You had sex.
Maybe.
Okay.
With my Zelda cartridge. No, I saw something.
Did you taste it yet?
No.
We should probably do that live on the show.
Sure. I was going to do it with the first cartridge that wasn't Zelda.
Oh, that's probably a good point.
Yeah. I mean, if you want to, go ahead with your cartridge.
No, I'll lick yours, but it's fine.
No one's licking my Zelda.
Tim, let me lick your cartridge.
No one's licking my Zelda.
Let me lick your cartridge, bro.
No.
Let me lick your cartridge.
No.
Let me lick it.
No.
Let me lick it, Tim.
That's the name of this episode.
Let me lick it.
No, let me lick it, Tim. So, before I went to the midnight launch...
He let me lick it.
No. I was on Facebook Market. I was on Facebook and I saw this marketplace notification that someone was giving away
a Nintendo Switch.
No.
Why are you always telling me no?
Because you say stupid things.
No.
You want me to tell the story or not?
Yes.
Okay. So I saw that someone was giving away this decorative garden slab.
Oh, fuck
with, like,
me.
A
that
Greek,
was creepy.
A Greek or Roman god on it. I think it's Bacchus or possibly Dionysus. Dionysus is the Greek version. Bacchus is the Roman version.
Okay.
But basically, he's the god of alcohol and partying.
Nice. That's cool.
Yeah. And he's
so he looks like he's vomiting.
He's got like grapes in his hair. He's also the god of vines and wineries.
Yeah, wines. Yeah.
Yeah, but getting drunk, basically. But he does look creepy. So this... Cheers.
Cheers. Hold up. Before you continue the story.
I'm never finishing the story.
No, you're never going to finish the story, guys. It's going to be a 2-hour episode. Thanks for the beer again, Michael from ASA Podcasting. We are trying the Flying Fish Brewing Exit 1 Bayshore Oyster Stout. Brewed with oysters.
This could be like
licking
a Switch cartridge. This could be bad. I'm glad it's subtle. I can taste it.
Oh, yeah.
It's not bad.
It's not bad, actually.
I was a little scared when I read the label.
Continue on. God of grapes in vineyards.
Here's to Bacchus. So someone was giving away their giant garden decorative slab because they were moving. And it was about 10 minutes south of where I had to go to pick up the Switch anyway.
Okay.
So this is like 10 o'clock at night, you got to realize. So I'm driving around part of Portland I'm not familiar with.
Breaking somebody's front yard.
No. I mean, it was like a... It wasn't an apartment. It was like a... Not a duplex either. It was like one of those...
Condos?
No. Just like one long building with apartments.
Yeah.
Like flat, but all single level.
Yeah.
And it was the first one, fortunately, because it was like... They just said first come, first serve, just pick it up. So I'm like, I hope someone wasn't pranking them, but it had the address and everything on the listing.
Huh.
I just rolled up, popped the back of my van... It carried it. It was heavy. It was pretty heavy. It said,
It said bring two people or one strong man.
I'm like, well, okay.
You're like, if not, I don't deserve this.
Yeah, so I got my Bacchus in the back. Peeled out of there. There was a couple walking their dog that was kind of looking at me.
Like, what the fuck is this guy doing?
Maybe I should get out of the neighborhood now. But, I mean, I got away with it. And pretty sure that they were actually giving it away, not just someone. Hey, I hate that thing my neighbor has. Let's see if I can get rid of it. So I put it in my back garden, kind of skipping ahead, kind of behind some shrubs. It looks really cool, kind of peeking out from the shrubbery. It is kind of creepy, like you said.
That's pretty cool.
Especially though. When it rains, it gets all like mottled and mm-hmm. creepy looking. It's awesome.
That's really cool.
So, yeah, got a cool little conversation piece from my garden grove.
Nice.
And anyway, I went on to Best Buy, and there was a line around the building. I sent you pictures. It was a decent line, like 40 people maybe.
Yeah, not huge. Terrible.
The PS4 line, launch line, was way bigger. So I didn't go in that line because I had it pre-ordered. I kind of hung out up front, and they were passing out. I could have gotten my Pro Controller that day, although I did see the last one get passed out right in front of me.
Really?
Well, I already had mine ordered from GameStop in the mail. I got it the next day. So they were passing out, like I said, slips that had...
Yeah, my cousin was fifth in line.
Wow.
Yeah, at the one that you went to.
You didn't need slips for Joy-Cons. Like, they just had stacks of them. Like,
really?
If you wanted to buy extras, no problem.
If you wanted to buy extra left sides, no problem?
Yeah, yeah. I'm not buying the first version of left side. I might buy the second version.
I haven't had a single problem with mine.
I haven't either, but I haven't played the correct way to have a problem. But
yeah, me either.
So anyway, there's a bit of confusion with the line. Like, even though we were the pre-orders, he's like, okay, you pre-order guys go first, but we're just going to have one line. I'm like, okay, cool. So I get in there, I'm probably like 7, 8 from the front.
Mm-hmm.
And then the guy at the register says, no, you pre-order guys go over to that register. I'm like, okay, cool, whatever. So I leave, and now I'm like third in line, going over to this other counter. And then the original guy that's directing line is like, no, we want one line. I'm like, okay, but the guy over there said to come over here. He's like, well, no, we want one line this time. I'm like, okay, so you want me to get back in the back of the line now? I'm not doing that. He's like, well, sir, you're welcome to sit here as long as you want. I'm like, no, you don't understand. I had a place in line,
yeah,
and now you're telling me I have to go to the back. I'm not doing that.
Yeah.
He let me stay there. And then, so I was third in line.
Nice.
So that was cool. It pissed me off for a second. Like,
I really think that you just need to stop supporting @BestBuy on Twitter and Instagram.
We have a complicated relationship. I spend a lot of money with them, and
you spend a lot of money with them.
I expect a just basic level of service, and they fuck things up a lot.
Yes,
but,
they do.
But I get good deals from them. So, like I said, it's kind of like the girl you call up at 3 a.m. You know she's a pain in the ass, but.
You just want to get laid.
You end up getting what you want, right?
Yeah, usually.
That's Best Buy is my whore. There it is. The other thing I've been doing this week is been kind of obsessed with this frog meme.
Frog? You talking about Pepe?
No, Pepe can suck my ass. He's a racist motherfucker.
Pepe is not racist!
He's so racist.
Pepe was not created to be racist.
He wasn't created to be racist, but he became racist.
That's because of Donald Trump.
Right. Well,
yeah.
He's tainted now.
Pepe! Senor Pepe!
Pepe's a bitch.
You're Pepe's bitch. Wait, I think I broke my stand and now it actually works properly.
Is it bent?
Yeah, and it fucking works. And
okay, but does it snap shut? That's weird. Okay.
It sits back now, so it leans up.
So now it would work
again. Hey, break your fucking switch.
Get away from my switch.
Hey, wait, I was going to stand them up on the desk so people could look at them that are watching us on YouTube. You're a dick putting your switch away. Fine, put the headphones
on. Whatever, I got to use them already. So, yeah, this is probably like an ancient meme for most people.
Talking about Pepe.
No, it's not Pepe. It's actually not a frog meme.
Pepe the racist frog, apparently.
So, it's actually Shooting Stars meme. It's this...
What?
It's this repetitive song that, like, gets into your head, but... People have made videos to it.
Talking about badger.
I'm gonna play it for you right now, just so we can get another copyright strike.
Yeah, thanks a lot, Fox. Fuck.
We'll talk about that later.
What the fuck? What is this? Wait, I've been like seeing people do like this type of shit with like different objects.
But the frog is my favorite.
What the fuck?
So I've been kind of obsessed with that because there's there's a lot of these.
That's weird.
Yeah, it is weird. So
that's really weird. Fat guy.
Yes, they like I've been watching this way too much.
Yeah,
At work now, my dishwashers just play that music for literally 3 hours at a time and drive everyone insane.
This
music, yes. Yeah, the one that we're gonna get a copyright strike for now. You're welcome, by the way.
It's okay, I'll fight the son of a bitch. I've had to fight like six copyright effects.
If they can make all these meme videos, why can't we play it in the background for like 3 seconds like we just did?
I don't know.
But anyway, it's if you want to look it up yourself, listeners, it's Shooting Stars
Compilations.
Shooting Stars by Beg something, I can't remember now.
Okay.
Go check it out. See lots of stupid crap. There's some really good ones I'll show you later. But in the meantime, what have you been up to this week?
So this week I got the Switch.
Yep.
How
did you get your Switch?
All my shit came in the mail. So my Switch actually came from Amazon.
You were worried.
I was very worried, and then you got me more worried when you were like, hey, I don't know if you've seen this article yet or not, but apparently Amazon like said they shipped, but they didn't ship the product.
I don't think Jorge's brother still has his.
But he doesn't.
Yeah.
So
it's out there.
Suck it, people! I got mine. You know what the problem is? Is Amazon probably put them up for a second run on Amazon, thinking they were going to get more. And all these people who didn't get them are probably second run.
Maybe.
So,
I hope they prioritize that way, because it would suck if...
No shit.
I mean, it sucks no matter what.
It does. Right? So, I got my Switch from Amazon. And as you guys saw a second ago, Tim got the neon-colored one.
Which is good, so we don't mix them up, apparently.
Exactly. And I got the black one. And I also got the Legend of Zelda Master Edition from Best Buy. But that also got shipped to me. So I was 100% shipped out on this console and leaving the next day for a business trip. So there might have been threats of gunpoint violence at Tim's house to get his Nintendo, but it all worked out.
Pause right now and mention that you did a really cool unboxing video for that, too.
Oh, I did do that, didn't I? Yes.
So you should check that out if you are wondering what's inside the Master Edition.
Yeah, the Master Edition. And actually, if you guys are watching...
Sugar Sword. I actually haven't seen it up close.
You haven't?
I haven't seen the Master Sword up close. This is the gayest episode we've ever done.
I don't know. That one PAX episode was pretty bad. He kept whipping out his Master Sword. So this is basically, I think, the only piece that differentiated mine from yours.
That and the packaging.
So it kind of... doesn't smell like it anymore.
It was smelling yours a lot in the video.
It smelled like cement and paint.
You said it smelled like paint.
Yeah. So, I don't know, maybe Tim has a different feeling, but I feel like this is some sort of rock cement or plaster paste.
I would think it would be resin more than rock.
Maybe,
but I don't know.
But it's like rock hard.
Mm-hmm.
And it smelled like spray paint when it came out of the box.
Wait, you can tell me your Master Sword is rock hard.
Master Sword is rock hard. This is the gayest episode. So it's also got the rust all around it, guys. Well, anyways, I'm going to hand this off to Tim. He can check it out. And you guys can head over to our YouTube channel and check out the unboxing video of it. The Master Sword isn't, like, super sturdy, but it's pretty cool.
I'm almost thinking it might be plastic.
Could be.
It does bend.
Yeah, it does.
I'd be worried to knock that over.
Yep, that's the reason why it just sits up
here.
That's
a good place for it, especially with young children in the house.
Exactly. So, I did that this week, and then I also flew to California for 24 hours and worked a trade show, and then flew back, sort of.
So, did you drain your Switch to zero?
I did.
So, how
twice.
Long?
How three long times.
Three times. How long did you get on each charge?
About 3 hours.
Cool. People are saying 2.5 to 3 hours, so
yeah,
it's good that you got the higher end.
The first time, put my screen brightness all the way down and had it on airplane mode. So it wasn't searching for Wi-Fi, and it wasn't searching for NFC or Amiibo support.
Cool.
So, I'm sure if I turn my screen brightness up, it'd probably been like 2.5 hours.
Okay.
But I said like halfway, then when it got down to like 20%, because there was no outlet, it turned all the way down. So, yeah, and then I got stuck in Seattle for like 5.5 hours. What was it, like midnight, 1 o'clock in the morning you picked me up from the airport?
12:30.
Yeah, so, thank you again.
You're welcome.
My wife, like, I got home.
I'm really glad I packed my Switch to work that day.
No shit.
Just happened.
Well, you would have had plenty of time with the amount of delays that I got.
Well, I had a whole meal at a bar and, like, a beer and everything while I was waiting for you.
That's what I mean. Like, you could have gone home and got it and...
Yeah. I was already closer to the airport there.
Oh, that's true. Yeah. So, anyways, that's what I did this week. And I'm back now. And video games!
Yes, we've been playing some. Mainly one, but we'll get to that.
Okay.
Have you played any other games besides the one we're going to end up talking about?
No.
Okay. So I had a few. I actually bought a couple other games for the Switch digitally. Snipper Clips, which I played with my son.
You like it?
Yeah, it's fun. Maybe I'll boot it up really quick during the break and show you.
Cool.
It's fun. It's a good two-player game. It's a cooperative puzzle game.
Huh.
I wish there was the capture function on... the Switch
already.
Now, but there isn't. There's just, you can just take stills. At some
which
point,
is pretty neat and handy.
It's
easy to do.
It's cool. I posted a picture like right away.
I haven't got to do it yet. I have a couple cool
I'm gonna make a
there.
Background for Facebook. For
nice.
My, yeah. Anyway, I've also played Fast RMX, which is kind of a cross between F-Zero and Wipeout, and so far I'm enjoying that a lot. It has... I haven't looked into whether it has online. I can't imagine it does that it wouldn't, but it does have local split screen, either 2 or 4 player. So I'm wondering how the controllers would work for 4.
We should try with 2.
We can try with 2. I made my mom try it. She's like, doesn't play video games, but actually, just hold this. I want to see if it works. And it worked.
Nice.
So yeah, that's a racing game set in the future, and it's got really cool backgrounds like. Totally futuristic.
Mm-hmm.
Different planets and things floating around.
That's cool.
It's cool. It's fun. I haven't played a lot of it, though, because... Well, wait. There's one other game I played. I did get to play Horizon Zero Dawn between Tuesday and Friday.
You didn't?
I did.
Okay.
A little bit. I'd say about 3 hours.
Not bad for you.
No, for me, it's
That's
not.
Pretty good from Monday through...
Enough to know that this is an awesome game that I want to come back to. But... Another game has my attention now.
Because the other game that's just like it...
It's really not, but there's definitely similarities. I don't care if people say there's not similarities. There are similarities. Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. Playing a bit of
it
that.
It took my breath away.
That's wild, Zach. So, you've played more of it than I have. You're kind of obsessive about that.
Yeah.
And you had your work trip, which, although parts of it sucked, it did give you an opportunity.
It gave me good opportunity.
Sounds like you played 9 hours just in your work trip if I added up the discharges of your battery correctly. So that's pretty good.
Roughly, yeah, probably.
So you got more shrines unlocked than I have. You've gotten further.
I'm up to like 12 shrines and like 4 towers or something.
I've got 8 and I apparently missed some, so I'll go back. But I wanted to get to Kokiri Village.
See, and that was my whole thing. As I set out, go in the Kokiri Village, and then was like, there's a tower off to the left. I'm going to that tower off to the left.
The game will accommodate either playstyle. If you want to go direct quest it, it'll let you. If you just want to wander around and find shit, it'll let you.
Although I will say, going to the left from Kokiri Village is a fucking bitch if you like aren't prepared for like running from creatures. Like if you try to fight them... It's like one hit kills on a lot of the shit. Because I chose stamina to start with, so I don't have like the health for it. And some of that shit over there is literally a one hit kill.
Yeah.
So.
Have you had a blood red moon yet?
What?
Yeah.
A blood what?
Blood red moon.
I've never paid attention to the moon color.
Oh, you'll know. There's a day night cycle in
life. Yeah.
Okay. Well, you'll know if you hit a blood red moon.
So how have I not hit one in all my playtime, and you have?
I have. Let's just say you want to stick close to a village unless you're really prepared.
Is that when all the zombies come out of the ground?
All sorts of shit. I saw a guardian in the field. I saw multiple goblins, like, big ass goblins everywhere. Like, just enemies spawn.
And it looks kind of red tinted on the screen or something?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
No, I've never had one.
Yeah. I went back to the village. I'm like, no, fuck this.
You just sat there?
No, I just went and talked to people, collected cuckoos, that kind of thing.
You just sit by the campfire and wait till morning.
Yeah. So, yeah, I love the game. It's a true open world game.
It really is.
And actually,
it loads super freaking fast. Like, if you're going in between, in and out of buildings, like, sometimes they're not even a load time. Sometimes the door just opens and you walk in and then you walk right back out.
It's a huge step forward for the series.
I've
just been kind of repeating Ocarina of Time for the last...
Over and over again.
Right.
Different skin, different time.
Like Twilight Princess especially was...
Just a knockoff.
So it was really good to see them really stretch their wings with this one. And
so I really like that it has futuristic elements into it. Like, it's like a... It's like the world got super fucking high-tech. And then it all just went to shit and collapsed.
Mm-hmm.
And now we're back to the Stone Age again. But there's, like, still these ancient relics, which kind of hints at Horizon Zero Dawn as well, from what I understand. But...
Well, Horizon Zero Dawn is very clearly set after the fall of civilization.
It's pretty
blatant about it.
Well, not, this game kind of is, too. So.
I mean, you kind of have a tablet.
Yeah. You kind of have a stone tablet, though. It's made out of stone.
Hey, Silicon Tech is coming, man.
I have a tablet.
It's sort of like that. Not quite as big, I think, in the game. It's similar.
It's pretty similar. It's probably about the size of the Switch.
Yeah, I think they're going for that.
Yeah. My tablet doesn't do all that cool stuff, dude.
No. I like it when you sync up with a shrine.
Yeah.
It's weird to see those kind of tech elements in a fantasy game, but it works.
It's a fun game. I really like it. I don't really want to spoil too much or talk too much about anything right now.
I think we've been vague, mostly. We just got around to using amiibos.
We did, for the first time.
And you definitely want to do that.
You definitely want to use amiibos.
I'm not going to say which ones you want to try. But, I mean... I'm not going to say which ones.
But if you're watching on YouTube, we don't have to say nothing. So... But, I mean, you really want to try some of them, and it just might be for your best benefit if you try some that are on the screen. And that's what the bottom of some of them look like. But anyways, it was cool. It was quick and easy. Don't try the amiibos if you're on the side of a cliff.
Yeah, you gotta kind of aim where the drop happens. There's a little reticle, and we both did that.
Yeah.
You go chase stuff off a cliff, which was funny.
Yeah. So, cool. Do you have a tech talk for this week?
I do have a tech talk this week.
Tech talk! Yeah, I'm everywhere.
It is actually kind of a kick it, too.
Kick it!
Do you remember Prepped?
Yeah, your food and meal service. Lunchbox thing.
Yep.
Oh wow, that is the thing that was in the thing. The fuck am I hearing?
Pull it out of the sleeve.
That's what she said. I can't.
I forgot you don't have fingers.
You're a dick. Oh.
Hey, it's upside down right now.
This is upside down?
That's upside down. Pull the little blue tab.
Okay, is this real wood?
It's bamboo.
That's super cool.
Yep.
Bamboo on the top, guys. It kind of goes around like a bread box. And that just showed my age, so that's great. Oh, it's got his nuts in here.
I brought us some tasty treats. So it's got a modular component. It's got like sort of Tupperware-esque containers, but they're way more high quality than Tupperware.
Now, can I... Yep.
It also has a set of magnetic silverware in there and some chopsticks. And then if you pull those, like one of those, I don't know what you call them.
These?
Yeah, pull one out. Or pull two on that side then. If you look on the side...
Oh, chopsticks!
Right, those chopsticks. But if you look on the side, there's a insert that has ice. Pull it out by the ring part shown on the camera. There's one on each side. It just comes out. It should just come out.
Did you get it out? I don't have good fingernails on that side. Yeah, it just comes out.
The chopsticks were holding it in.
Oh.
Okay, so maybe it doesn't come right out.
That's again what she said. Hey, don't hit my amiibos, you little fucker.
Bam, bam, bam.
If you really need an amiibo, you guys can check out their amiibos inside of Zelda Breath of
the Wild. I think the problem is I need to put the ring in the front, maybe.
Yeah, I think it might have fucked it.
Okay, well, these come out somehow because I just put them in. Wow. Okay, I'll have to figure that out. But anyway, it keeps it cool.
Okay.
And then it's got a little pad where you can put your lunch on. Like I said, these are magnetic, so they stick
together.
Now,
how much do these sell for?
I don't remember. I know it was a bit. Okay. I got several extra of these so I can pack them up ahead of time.
Nice.
Stack in my fridge, but...
It's really cool, man.
Yeah, the thing that makes this a tech talk, besides this being technology that's developed for a better lunch, is that it has an app. And
maybe, oh, wait. There's an app for that.
Thanks. So, I don't know if I should make a little video of me running the app, but I'll describe it to you briefly right now. There's different user-submitted meals that fit in these.
Okay.
And so, like, I've got one right now, sweet potato and slaw. So I say, okay, I want that one. So I push a little heart, and then I push a little apron.
And it tells you what you need to make.
It gives you a shopping list, so you go shopping, and then it tells you how to make it. So if you selected a bunch of recipes, it would build a shopping list for you.
Cool.
You go buy all the stuff, then you go cook it, store it, and then boom. So
awesome.
It's kind of an integrated system. It's neat.
That is really cool. And do you remember how much you paid for backing on this?
I don't, but I could look it up and tell you after the break.
Okay, sounds good, guys. We'll be right back with another tasty treat in hand and tasty treats in our mouth. Again. That's what she said.
There's a whole bunch of podcasts out there. You're not getting to listen to all of them. Join me, your Uncle Blake, and let me be your podcast Sherpa with the Earwash Show. I'll present a different podcast on each episode for your consideration. If you decide you like it, hey, give it a download. If not, well, I'll try again on the next episode. Besides my favorites and Apple's top picks, I want to hear what your favorites are so we can share them with the rest of the world. So send your favorites to earwashshow@gmail.com. Again, that's earwashshow@gmail.com. And let's get the good word out.
And we are back. More tasty treats in my tummy, and I sucked it down. And Tim's got a tasty treat in his hand.
Flying Fish Brewing,
yep.
Exit 16WE. I'm kind of confused about the bottom part.
West and East?
Maybe. Wild Rice Double IPA.
Huh.
It says, rice helps this beer ferment and dry to better showcase the five different hops we use. We then dry hop with generous amounts of Chinook and Citra to create a nose that hints of tangerine, mango, papaya, and pine.
Huh.
Sounds yummy.
Sounds very yummy.
Let's crack it.
Where did you get these?
Safely.
Really?
Yeah, it's like a peanut butter cup trail mix.
I like
it. It sounded good.
Sounds very good.
Ha ha ha. I didn't pour it sideways. I'm like, I'm gonna pour mine. Because I'm an asshole.
Just you wait, so. Tim loves giving me head, so it's just like, this episode's so fucked up.
Alright.
Hey, you got so much more beer than me, asshole.
This one looks good. It doesn't have an oysters in it, so I'm more excited for it. So you can drink that in about 5 minutes.
Yep.
Have some more jerky. Mm-hmm. Put some more meat. Put some more meat in your mouth. Cheers.
Cheers, asshole. I gotta chew this first. Is it good?
It's really good. Kind of sharp and clean. I like it.
Ready to kick it?
Let's kick it. Alright, so I missed this one somehow. I would have featured this one a long time ago. There's only 8 days left as we're recording this. So it'll end next Wednesday. You still have time to back it as you're hearing this, if you hear it when it comes out on Saturday or Sunday.
Okay.
But you need to get on it if you want to back it.
That's what she said.
So I saw this game at the PlayStation Experience, and I'd never heard of it before that time, and I was very excited after playing it for it to come out. And it's almost done for PlayStation 4 and Xbox One. And the game is called Arrow. It's a rhythm rail shooter.
This would be perfect on a Switch, by the way.
It would work on a Switch, and I'm sure they've at least thought of that. But they are a small two-man development team. They've been developing this for several years. And to put a game on Steam costs a bit of money. Not a lot. Not a lot, but a fair enough. Enough to, for where they are with their budget, they need to kickstart getting it onto Steam. So they've already cleared the hurdles for the console release. And it sounds like the Steam build is completely ready. It's just a matter of funding to get it on there. So they're asking for support to get this onto Steam. The developer, by the way, is Matt Fellows, one of the two guys I was talking about.
Keep talking to him. I'll be right back.
Yep. Tetra's upset about something. So they are asking for, in U.S. dollars, $2,400 basically. And like I said, they have 8 days to go, and they have 112 backers already. And they've got really good backing levels to get in on. You can pledge about $6 just for a thank you and digital wallpapers. $13 gets you a Steam digital edition. $19 gets your name in the credits. $19 also could get you an Xbox One digital edition or a PlayStation 4 digital edition. And these only become available as they get the code, so they're kind of refreshing these. As I record this, they have some in each category, but it looks like they kind of run out and then restock. For $63, you can get two Steam codes plus a special message listed on the game. So you could like propose to your girlfriend or say happy birthday to somebody. And like I said, you get two codes. So going up to the highest level, like we like to do, which is $625, you get Dan's actual pants. Limited to at least to six only, as we need him to have at least one pair of pants left. Dan the programmer's actual underpants, worn by Dan himself and maybe or maybe not the source of his programming powers. I haven't discussed this with him yet, but I'm sure he'll be happy to sign them, and he'll throw in all the other rewards and 8 copies of the game to keep you from thinking too hard about your terrible choice of rewards. So a bit about the game. It's got a great soundtrack. I'm going to mispronounce some of these, I just know, so I apologize to the artist. So you got Flux Pavilion, KDB, Laura Bram, Egnos, Subhuman, Megalodon, Neosignal, Noisia, Prototypes, Barely Alive, Hobstract, Astronaut, and Mr. Fiji Ouija. The game sounds awesome. The soundtrack it's a pounding bass beat.
Oh, Mr. Fiji Ouija.
And it's really fun. Like, if you... It's on rails, but if you sync it up right, like, the beats increase in the song, and you really feel like you're part of the music, and it's just, you get pumped when you play it. It's a lot of fun. There's boss battles, it's, like, futuristic in your little spaceship. It's a good game.
Cool.
I can't wait to play it. I was planning on playing it on PlayStation 4, but I may have backed this one. So
on Steam.
On Steam. We're going to bring it to Steam, people. We're going to make it happen.
We're going to make a steamy up in here. Where's going to keep going, buddy?
No. Okay, so that's Arrow, the rhythm rail shooter. Check it out. Back it. It's awesome. What do you have for us, Zach?
You ever been a douchebag with a selfie stick?
No. I want to be a bigger douchebag than that.
I got the perfect thing for you.
All
right. It's called the Selfly camera, the smart flying phone case camera.
Where do I sign up?
At Kickstarter.com. Along with the 7,226 other backers of the Selfly camera. So if you're one of those douchebags that loves to take pictures of yourself and just can't get enough...
Two more people just signed up while you're talking.
Great. Or you're one of those creepers that try and get the panty shots and just want a nice fly low drone. Just, well,
they're gonna do that, aren't they?
Yeah, they are.
I didn't think of that.
Or the cleavage at the bar that we saw, and Tim and I were like, no way in hell is this.
No bartenders ever allow a fucking selfie drone to fly around a bar.
No. Let's just let them describe it and then we can rip on it.
There are moments you want to cherish from your unique point of view. Moments you can't recreate. When you want to experience and capture the moment at the same time. When you need to unleash your camera and let it fly. Introducing Selfly, a smart autonomous flying camera that doubles as a 9mm thin phone case. It is with you at all times, ready to capture and share the perfect shot you could only dream of. Selfly takes off and hovers autonomously, operated in real time through your phone to catch the perfect shot you want. Selfly flies by itself like an invisible tripod, easily controlled by adjusting the frame with simple hand gestures. Selfly is a smart flying camera. Anything your smartphone is able to detect or process could be sent to control Selfly and enable incredible features like face and smile recognition, sweep panoramic, or even follow your movements. And of course, you can share them instantly on all your social platforms. Selfly folds to a 9mm slim design thanks to the unique motor folding mechanism, so it can easily fit comfortably in your pocket. Selfly is your point of view from a new, exciting angle. Be the first to get Selfly by supporting us on Kickstarter.
So the
that's not gonna work.
The skateboarding video, kind of cool.
I can see a couple purposes that'd be pretty cool. If you're out on a hiking trail and you want like a really far away shot, but it just hovers there. It doesn't like you can't fly it out. So skateboarding, cool. Maybe at the beach in the water, kind of cool, I guess.
Not in the bar.
I mean,
I see that in a bar. I'm taking a pool cue and swapping it down.
Yeah, and I'm shoving the pool cue through the center of it just to make sure the damn thing's
dead. Finger's dead. So, how much do one of these bad boys run?
All right, Tim, that is the granddaddy question of all. You can give me a Selfly fan for $5. $5, they'll allow you to be a fan at.
How about I'm not for free?
You can get one for $99.
All right.
You can get one with two phone cases for $109. You can get a Selfly camera kit plus one Selfly power bank for $120. Double everything, $185.
Double douche.
Double douche. Jumping up to $89. Those are all gone brackets. $990 Super Family Douche Pack plus power banks, 10 Superfly douche cameras with 10 douche cases. Any models, 10
it's
douche
like
power banks.
Frat boy special.
This is the frat boy
no,
special.
No, sorority. Come on, let's be real.
No, it might be frat boy too. It depends.
That's true. There are some pretty boys out there.
Yeah. Universal connector for all 4 to 6 inch mobile phones, and you can choose your preferred phone model and color in a backer survey upon completion of the campaign.
Damn, but they do have my phone.
Where do you see that?
Right there.
Right where?
Middle screen on the right.
Right here?
All the way to the right.
Huh?
Yeah. There.
Where?
In the middle, see?
Oh, yeah.
I'm not getting one, people. Don't worry.
They don't have mine. Oh, they do. Fuck.
You can be a douche with
I
me.
I can be a sample. We can be this super duble douche.
We can, like, walk around, like, swaggering, like,
hey. Like, with drones following us, like,
check my Instagram.
So they
put, post Instagram automatically for you?
It might.
It should.
It could do Facebook Live. Hey guys, what's going on?
I mean, that'd be kind of cool for bags. Damn it! I'm turning into a douche as we speak.
Somebody run to the pharmacy aisle, grab Tim a douche. CNET's talked about this. MSN Video. Is that even a fucking thing? Yahoo Tech. Who the fuck? Mashable. Okay. Digital Trends. Mail 1. Gadget Byte. Vodafone.
Dude, they might as well. A lot of bloggers talked about them. Yeah. A lot. There's like a whole screen of them. Forbes.
These are a lot of super douches. Okay, anyways, guys, so it looks like a super douche machine with a camera and a drone attached. If you thought drones weren't elitist enough, here's the super douche elite drone.
It's almost got $1 million. It's at 900 grand, pretty much.
I'm looking at this, and another person just backed with 56 hours ago, so I'm glad to tell you, you can't be a super douche at these low entry costs. You have to pay the high price if you want to be a super douche.
Woohoo!
Woohoo! All right, guys, that is our this week's Kick It. On over to game industry news.
I don't really have a lot.
Okay,
Switch came out. That was news.
Yep, Switch, Zelda.
There's been some issues with the Switch.
A little bit.
You don't want
Zelda cartridge tastes nasty. Tim said he'd let me lick his, but now he decided he's not going to let me lick his.
PlayStation Plus games came out.
Okay, what do we got?
Today, actually some decent ones for once. The last 2 months have been really disappointing. So, Disc Jam, do you remember that demo I told you to download? It's a free game.
That's cool.
Hopefully it'll have kind of like Rocket League potential. It looks like a fun pick-up-and-play, fast-paced game.
Nice.
Tearaway Unfolded, which was originally a Vita game.
Yeah, I remember you playing that.
It's a fun little game. Everything looks like papercraft, and you interact with the environment a lot. I'm not sure how they... Yeah, the Vita has a lot more input options.
It does.
Like, I imagine...
The back panel and everything.
I imagine they do a lot with the DualShock controller, but it's not going to be quite the same.
Yeah.
But it still looks cool. Then we got Undernight Inbirth EXE Late for PS3. As you might have guessed, that's a anime-inspired game from NIS. It's a fighting game.
Oh, no fucking way.
The Earth Defense Force 2025. That's only a couple years from now, no? Shit.
Oh, well.
So that's from PS3. That's the one in the series where you fight giant insects.
Okay.
And it actually looks like a lot of fun.
Huh.
I played one of the first ones. I had fun with it. It's dumb. You're the soldier. You run around cities. They're being destroyed by giant insects. You shoot them.
That's kind of cool.
It is. It's good, simple, dumb fun. For Vita, we've got Severed, which I covered although I owned the Vita version, I covered the 3DS version, but bought special.com if you read my review. But it is kind of a dungeon crawler, very colorful, and you slash the enemies on the screen.
That's cool.
With your finger on the Vita. It's pretty cool. Lumo is a puzzle game.
Lumino.
It's isometric, I think. It's where you're looking three-quarters perspective.
I believe so.
It looks really cool. Like, the art style is really neat. Hmm. And it's, you're like this little wizard guy. It looks like the wizard from He-Man. Remember the...
Yeah.
And you're jumping through all these traps and stuff.
That's cool.
So I'm going to download and check that out on my Vita for sure.
Sweet.
Also, just to let you guys know, it's not a PlayStation Plus game, but there is a free VR demo. Cyber Danganronpa VR, the class trial, is available. So if you have a PSVR, I mean, you should check out the free demo.
Yeah.
And then, well, I could mention this, but it'll be too late by the time you hear it, so never mind. You could vote on which game gets a discount, but it ends March 8th, which is tomorrow.
Yep, that's tomorrow.
So
what'd you vote for?
I voted for Hitman, the complete season.
Okay. The of the new one?
Yeah.
Nice.
The other one was Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2.
Yeah, that'd be stupid. Hitman would be fun. I would like to come and try
that
out.
I think that was
a
50% discount, too, so...
Wow.
I'll look and see if that wins in a couple days.
Sweet.
That's really all the game news I got. I mean, I didn't see much else going on out there. I think
it's Zelda.
Everybody else was playing Zelda instead of writing news. I think what happened.
Pretty fucking positive. It's been pretty dead, other than, hey, my left stick stopped working, people.
Yeah, we haven't had that issue yet, but we haven't.
But we're also not using it the way that they used it.
Right, playing behind an aquarium.
Or just, I'm not behind playing it. Yeah, I'm not. Or I'm also just not playing it.
Before I got my Pro, I was using it roughly 7 feet from the console, and it was fine.
Oh, really?
I
haven't tried mine on TV yet. So
when I sit in my giant sack to play console games, it's about 7 feet away from the console.
I love Tim's sack.
It's very comfy.
Yeah.
It kind of warmly envelops you.
Yeah.
Protects you, supports you.
Yep.
It's a good place.
Mm-hmm. All right, guys. So this week, coming out today... We have Ghost Recon Wildlands, PC, PS4, Xbox One. Near Automata PS4, Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3 PC, PS4, Xbox One, Lego Worlds PS4, Xbox One, Ulterior Furious, The Alchemist, and The Mysterious Journey. Did I say that right?
Close enough.
Sure. PC, PS4, Vita, Clicker Heroes, Click Your Fucking Hearts Out, PS4, Darknet, PSVR. We gotta try that.
I think I played that on my Samsung. I really do think I played it. It's like a hacking game.
Huh.
It wasn't that good. Sorry. The next one is a fun title. Dino Dini's Kickoff Revival for PS4 and Vita with Crossbuy.
That's cool.
Disc
Jam.
So you can buy it if you're not a PlayStation Plus, but I mean, I am.
Or you could just pay for the PlayStation Plus that 1 month and just call it good.
You'll lose it once you give it up.
Oh, that's fucking stupid.
Yeah, it's not like gold.
Gem Smashers, PS4, Vita. Loot Rascals, PS4. Shit Happens.
Nope.
I know.
How many kids are going to run with like wide out on the cases?
Shift, yeah. Me.
Remember Bad Mother Truckers?
Yeah.
So dumb.
Shift Happens, PS4, Sublevel Zero, Redux. Why is everybody adding Redux to their fucking name, PS4? I think Redux is the newest gay thing. Like, whenever you come around, I'm like, oh, you're a super douche. Talisman Digital Edition, PS4, Vita, with Crossbuy. Total Jigsaw, PS4.
So unearthing. Put a puzzle together?
Probably.
Or is it Total Jigsaw, like the hero of the song movies? Because that would be cool. Total Jigsaw. Do you want to play a game? Close enough. While you look that up, Unearthing Mars comes out for PSVR, and Verdun comes out for Xbox One. The next one I'm probably going to buy, because it's a cool retro feel. Blaster Master Zero for 3DS.
Blaster? Is that like Math Blaster?
No, it's a Sunsoft game, and it came out for NES like way back in the day. I think this is a reimagined version of it. But it definitely has the feel.
No, it's definitely...
Oh, jeez. It's literally you put puzzles together?
Yep. Well, there was a zombie and a skull puzzle.
I don't care if the pictures are cool.
Challenge yourself with a 1,000-piece puzzle, Tim.
No. Just...
Cozy log fire 1,000-piece puzzle.
Put an actual puzzle together.
No. You are on the screen.
All right. Friday, Too Dark comes out for PS4.
Oh, my God. Look, you have to look over all the pieces, Tim. There could be 1,000 pieces.
What if it was PSVR and you had to pick up the pieces?
Oh, that would see.
Then, like, put them on the
see?
Board.
See, now Tim's buying it.
No,
Tim,
no, this
shut
looks
up.
Like the cure for insomnia. Oh my God, you rotate the pieces. No, those little fireworks go off if you do the puzzle.
Yeah, it looks like you won.
Do you remember Fantavision? It was a launch title for PS2.
Uh-uh.
It was a game where you literally lit fireworks and watched them blow up.
That's kind of cool.
For $50 or $60?
No, not that price point.
That was a launch game. This reminds me of that. Let's build a puzzle. No. Okay, let's talk about a game where I might actually play. It's called Voez for Switch, and it was originally a mobile title. And
okay.
If you check out our YouTube channel, you can see a quick look. Because you might want to check this out, because this is the first Switch game that doesn't have a TV mode. You only play it on the Switch tablet. But the songs were really cool that I got to try out. Kind of like K-pop and other, you know, peppy little songs.
Like Pepe the Frog?
No. There was no Pepe the Frog. Stupid frog. I'd shoot that frog inside if I saw him.
Why?
It's a racist motherfucker.
He's not.
Yes, he is.
He's just falling in with the bad crowd, Tim.
Well, he needs the correction of my fist to his face.
Well, that's okay, but not shooting Pepe. That is racist.
Anyway.
Pepe is a Mexican frog. You can't shoot Mexican stuff, Tim. You're white.
I can shoot a Mexican frog.
Mexicans would disagree.
I think the Mexicans would throw him back over the wall at us. So, Voez for Switch. Check out our video. See if it's a game you'd like. The interesting thing is it's free to play on mobile, but you have to pay for all the songs downloads. So, there's 100 songs. So, for $20 on Switch, that might actually be a better value proposition. You get all the songs and future DLC.
That's pretty cool.
So, check it out.
Sweet.
Until next time, Zach.
Don't forget to check us out at youtube.com/plugandplaygamer, where if you are watching this, hit the like button, subscribe, leave us a comment. Check us out, facebook.com/plugandplayshow. Twitter and Instagram at plugandplaycast. Until next week, guys, don't forget to prime and play Zelda.